All right, so this piece is called Shaking.
I feel it. Oh, I feel it. I feel my dream shaking me. I can see it almost reaching. I know this is where I'm supposed to be.
Shaking to your core. When you finally realize you were purposed for breaking through closed doors, but not traditionally. God often has an unconventional method of making history. The facts lie with the director behind the scenes of the uncut version of life. He saw fit to shape you in his image so that every time someone sees you, they get a glimpse of him. And there's nothing new under the sun, but also respect that he only made one of you. You are the only one. And he wants you to shine bright like his son. So bright that your light makes the shade come on. So bright that your light emits heat from your tongue. So every time that you speak, obstacles burn down. And people are healed when you open your mouth. He fashioned you in his likeness so that every time someone's in your presence, they're reminded that they should be grateful for what they have and don't seek for another half. You are complete if you believe it. You are destined for greatness and distinguished if only you receive it. You are successors of success, the blessings of the best. Always chosen, never in a contest, because he only made one of you. Be grateful for yourself. Be happy that you cannot be just like anyone else they're already taking. Be firm in your decisions. Be patient with patience. It's a learned characteristic. The hardest lessons in life are often simplistic. Be great. Don't miss this. There's only one of you. Now stop and think for a minute about how your life can make all of the difference. Now think about him. Arms stretched beyond comfort, exchange the smile for struggle and a grimace. Replace the beautiful complexion with ripped lacerations, head held high, now dangling, hanging like a frame. He was framed because of his name before he was born. When you finally realize what you've been purposed for, it shakes you to your core. And he knew. He asked for an alternative for that cup to be removed, but you cannot move a cup that's overflowing without spilling the contents. Your excess was not to be all-consuming, but to awaken your conscience. To pour into others who are empty. All rebuilds for God's children are free, unlimited, bottomless, duty-free. Just be you. Don't worry about the what. Focus solely on the who. There is only one of you. And one is surely enough if you live to embrace rather than remove your cup.